My name is Honorable Kenneth Ozo. I am the Director General of this foundation. The name of this foundation is Amade AGF Women Foundation for the empowerment of women and girls. Our principal is coming back from Canada. And there is need for us to come and work on her. That's why we are here. The benefit of this foundation is to empower women and the youth. You know, in our society, women take a lot of pains to raise their children. They are the custodian of these children. And again, they do a lot in their house, in their homes. That their own struggles are not being recognized by the men. This NGO is focusing on them, to empower them, to give them a sense of belonging, to make sure that their struggle and their work in their homes are recognized. That was to my people is to embrace this NGO, to embrace it, and then encourage the principal. Is the Princess Calista. Yes, she's doing very well. She has supported the people. She has done a lot for the youth and the women in our own locality. Okay. Okay. Okay.
First of all, I'm Lady Agnes Akunebo from Ubuta. I'm the woman leader of the organization. Amen. See there on our piece inscribed on the this flag place and when the IJ Women Foundation. A lot of significance. A lot of them can't mention them, but let's start with the youth and the women. It's purely a foundation that has come out to make sure that the women are well placed in the society and the youth, which are the main people. Supposed to be looked for, supposed to be taken care of.
Then why do you people gather here today?
We are here just to receive our principal, just like my DG said. She has been away to Canada for some period of months. Now that she's coming back, we need to come to the airport to welcome her back. And that's the more reason why we're here.
What's the effect of women, especially in
the effect of women is they need empowerment. The women need help. And this is a woman who has sacrificed everything she has to help women. So there is need to follow this foundation as if they will have their betterment.
What are
the youth? The youth, yes. You can see a lot of things happening. The youth are unemployed. Nothing is happening. So she has also volunteered herself to make sure that the youth and the women are okay.
So you think that with this very foundation, that the youth and women from your area will benefit a lot?
I think so, because she has all it takes. She's skillful and she's knowledgeable. She will do it.
Okay. My name is
We are here. My youths are here to welcome a woman of substance. A woman who have said that born at those days where the youths will be used for crisis and everything. Women who believe that there is no need for you to venture into cultism. Rather, a woman that has produced herself to make the youth to see the future. A woman that has formed a particular group called Amede Aje Foundation for youth and youth and women empowerment. Okay, the expectation from the youth is not far-fetched. One, We are not expecting more from her. We are here to say thank you to this woman that have done a lot for the youth. This woman has empowered the youth of the local government. We are here to encourage some other women that have the kind of mind. But this woman is a man, is a woman clothes. This woman is a woman that she is a widow. This woman is a woman that believes that even if you are a youth that you, and you don't have a mother, that she is there for you as a mother. So what we are expecting from her, she has almost done everything. We are just here to say thank you to her.
Finally, what are your prayers for her?
Our prayers for her is for the good God to grant her all her heart desire. For the good God to place her in the place of political opportunity. Because an individual cannot have all the financial muscle to do what she has in mind. We are here to pray that God will place her in a political position where she will have every resources to take care of the youth of the local government and beyond.
Garden here is set of an Amazon. The woman that has not only brought to life, the woman that has put her life on the line, the woman that has gone beyond the time to the presentations, she has done, she has encouraged more than the employers. And she is not stopping them. For what is it? These are youth and women are gathered on their own to welcome the Amazon that have done what we never expected to do. Point of correction, we are not here on political ground. She is not contesting any election. Yes. We are not here on political ground. We are here because she has touched life. And we pray, if it is the wish of God, if by tomorrow or next she venture into facing the election, we need not be because she is certainly. My prayers for her and others is, if an individual, a woman for that matter, would do this on the road, what do you think will happen when she has gotten back? They call her Ayamasa. My traditional ruler personally conferred her with the title of Atatu, but I call her Afuogun Afifogun because she has beaten so many men. And the youth of the local government are living testimonies. The youth, the women as well. Wherever she goes, they have always prayed for her day and night. Her success is at the fact of her mind that she must achieve it in Jesus' name.
What are your words for the women and the youth as well?
I'm not sure if I have much to tell the women because already they are the worst. So we speak of women wherever we go. They are not only encouraged, they have done. In fact, I wouldn't have words to say about women because if they could put up this without the woman in question knowing, in fact, it was at the airport that she got to know that something like this is happening. So what can they not do? So I encourage them and I praise all of you women. Thank you and keep it up.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.